How to eliminate bubbles using pressure, featuring the duoMatrix Neo polymer-modified gypsum system. Now, in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can use pressure chambers and compressed air to eliminate any kind of air bubbles out of your castings. Now, my project here today has a lot of fine detail that I'm worried the air bubbles are going to get trapped in and produce air bubbles on the surface of the finish. The mold itself has a lot of deep crevices and is very thin-walled in certain sections. So I want to make sure that the material that I pour into the mold makes it into the deepest crevice of our mold. And for that reason, I will be using compressed air and an air pressure tank. Now, our goal for this video today is very simple. We want to eliminate any kind of air bubbles trapped in the material that could transfer into our castings. Now, let's just jump into this and see how it's done. So here we have a comparison shot, a casting done without pressure on the left and a casting on the right that's done with pressure. The casting on the left was made without pressure, and because of that, resulted in a number of air bubbles being trapped on the surface of the casting. The nose cavity in the mold was not filled, and our casting now has a missing nose. A casting like this would be deemed a failure and have to be redone. To pressure or not to pressure? That's the question. Now, this question comes up very often. I feel it's really important to understand which one does what. Pressure casting is the process of using a pressure chamber and a compressor to eliminate bubbles from casting resins or mold rubber. When you mix up material, the action of mixing the components together introduces a lot of air into the material. To get rid of the air, we're going to expose it to elevated pressure. While regular air pressure is about 14 psi, we are going to pressurize the material to 60 psi inside that pressure tank, and that way squeeze the bubbles that are in the material until they're no longer present. The action of vacuum degassing is when material for either mold making or casting that has been mixed is exposed to a vacuum in a vacuum chamber, and the air bubbles that have been previously added into the mixture by mixing the components together are now sucked out of the material, and that can be observed through a rise and fall of the material that's subjected to vacuum. Generally speaking, if you have pressure available to you, that will solve almost any bubble issue you may encounter, whether making a mold or casting. This mold is made with MoldMax 20, which is a tin-based 20-durometer silicone. One thing to keep in mind is if you're already planning to pressurize a specific casting, you need to understand that the mold itself needs to be made under pressure as well. If the molds are not pressurized during the curing process of the rubber, the air bubbles in the rubber will be trapped. Now, when you go to cast into that mold and you apply pressure to the mold and to the material, the pressure will push the casting material into the microscopic bubbles on the surface of your mold, creating a casting that's full of dimples and will be not acceptable and deemed a failure. For our casting today, I am using the duoMatrix Neo, which is a polymer-modified gypsum system. Now, this product has a mix ratio of 2A to 1B by weight or volume. The working time or pot life of the material is 30 minutes, and a cure is achieved after 90 minutes. If you take a look at the technical bulletin under the pouring section, it's going to have recommendation of how to further minimize any air bubbles in your castings, and it will specifically talk about pressurizing your casting once the material is poured. If your mold box is made out of melamine board or wood, like mine here is, make sure to put some sonite wax to seal that porous wood surface so that the duoMatrix Neo does not firmly mechanically lock into it.
After a thorough pre-mixing of the part B, we can go ahead and dispense the part A by volume, two parts, while the part B gets dispensed one part by volume. I tap the dispensing cups here to make sure I have equal amount of powder dispensed in both cups. And then I can go ahead and dispense the part B, which is the liquid component. And then we're going to mix the components into a clean mixing container. Keep in mind that just like in baking, we're going to be mixing the dry components into the liquid. This will help minimize any kind of lumping in the material. So we're going to sift the powder into the mixing container, and using a variable speed drill with a mechanical mixer, we're going to combine the two components together. By tilting the mixing container on the side, I'm able to concentrate the mass off material. Now I'm able to submerge the entire mechanical mixer and give the entire batch of material a good mixture. The material is now poured in the lowest part of the mold, and we're going to pour about a third of the material into the mold, and we're going to slush the material around inside the mold. So just tilt it back and forth until it coats all the areas off the mold itself. Again, this will minimize any kind of air bubbles that can be trapped on the surface of our casting. And now the rest of the material is poured into the mold. I like to clean the edges of the mold box here so that they don't cause any locking and sticking later on. And now our casting material can be exposed to some pressure. We're going to be using the pressure chamber here. This is a 5-gallon pressure chamber set on the side. I already leveled out the tank, making sure that it's level in both directions. And now the lid can be put onto the tank and tightened firmly. Notice here that I'm tightening opposing bolts to equally apply pressure over the entire rim. And now the opposing bolts are tightened as well. And now we're going to apply the pressure via air compressor. And with this lever here, we're allowing the pressure to enter the chamber. We're going to allow this a full compression, and it's automatically going to stop at about 60 psi. The material is now allowed a full cure for 90 minutes inside the pressure chamber under pressure. 60 psi is an ideal setting to compress any air bubbles that are trapped in the casting material or in your molding rubber. Keep in mind that regular air pressure is somewhere between 14 and 15 psi. So by exposing our castings to 60 psi, it's more than sufficient to take care of the bubbles that are trapped in the product. Keep in mind that pressure chambers can be dangerous. Homemade pressure chambers that don't have the structural strength to withstand the pressure that is being applied to them can rupture and potentially injure you. It's advisable to purchase pressure chambers from known manufacturers that have been tested and known to withstand the operating pressure. Once fully cured, we can depressurize the pressure chamber. There's a valve that you open for depressurization. It allows the air to escape slowly and not in one big gulp violently. The lid to the pressure chamber is now removed, and we can retrieve our fully finished casting. And as you can see here, the material has fully hardened, and we're ready to demold. Now, to get the mold out of the mold box, I will unscrew the box apart. It makes the removal of the silicone mold much easier. And now the mold is peeled back slowly to reveal our finished casting. The duoMatrix Neo copied everything inside the mold down to the smallest detail. And because we use the pressure chamber, our casting is bubble-free on the entire surface and is deemed a success. Now, if you got inspired by this project and you'd like to give your own projects a go and need some material, you can visit any one of our distributors around the world.
So, and there you have it, a step-by-step procedure that I use to eliminate any kind of air bubbles out of my castings. Now, let's just review our project for today here. We were able to achieve our goals of eliminating any air bubbles out of our castings simply by using a pressure chamber and compressed air. Now, if you have an idea about what we should do next, please let us know down in the comments below. And if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button. To keep up with our latest mold making, casting, and other videos, remember to subscribe.